Hi, you guys. Oh my god, yo, I have so many books for this book haul that I'm about to give y'all. I didn't think that it was this many, but what can I say? Books got the best of me. Hello, my little butterflies, and this video is going to be my postpartum slash March book haul. Okay, yeah, so while I was pregnant, I didn't really buy books. Like, I may have bought a book, like, maybe one or two here, a month or whatever. But it's been a long time since I did a book haul. And I don't do book hauls often because I don't like to spend too much money on books every month. Because it's ridiculous, because I end up with a whole bunch of books on my shelf that I haven't read, which is, like, my situation right now. So it's rare that I do book hauls now. I used to do them every month, like when I was losing my mind, but now it's like more of every few months I might do a book haul. And this one was well needed because, like I said, when I went on my maternity leave, I wasn't working, so I feel like it was more important for money to go to our bills and things for Kalea versus spending all this money on books, which, since I started working again and it's income tax season, so y'all see where this is headed. I went insane, okay? And all of these books are from Amazon, and next month I'm going to buy the books that I want off a book outlet that have been sitting in my book cart since like Black Friday that I was supposed to get. But then I changed my mind. I said, well, I'll wait until after I had the baby and after we have everything for Claire. So that's going to be next month, because I didn't want to go crazy and go too overloadish, because that's like 10 books on book outlet that I'm getting. Okay, but jumping into this book haul, I think 11 or 12 books, okay? And three of these books I bought before I bought this bulk order of books that I got off Amazon, okay? So first of all, let me start with the books that I got for Kalea, because usually when I buy myself books, I try to buy Kalea a book or two too, so that way I'm getting her books too. The first book that I got for Kalea off Amazon was Goodnight Moon by Margaret Wise Brown, and the pictures are by Clement Hurd. Now, I read this to her this morning at like 5 o'clock in the morning, because she went to sleep around 10 last night. She woke up at 5 o'clock this morning, and I was at work last night, so when I got home, she was already asleep. So when she woke up this morning, she was talking my goddamn head off. When I tell you, I've never heard a baby do so much baby talk in my life. I've never heard a baby do so much baby talk in my life. Like, she has a mouthpiece on her. But I read this for the first time to her this morning. She wasn't really feeling it because she was already sleepy and she was fighting her sleep, so she was cranky. So I'm going to try this again later on tonight maybe, after she's fed and while she's not cranky. But I love Goodnight Moon as a child, so I always wanted to get this book for her, and I wanted to get it earlier, but I don't know why I didn't. But hopefully I'm going to try this again tonight, and hopefully I get a better response out of her than I did this morning. The next book that I got for her, I read this the day that I got these books, and that is Scruffy the Tugboat by Gertrude Crampton, and it's a little golden book. And oh my god, Scruffy the Tugboat is the bomb, okay? Now, I sit this and read this whole book to her, and she didn't care. I mean, yes, she was paying attention to me, but she wasn't like, oh my god, mommy, this shit is so awesome, you know, whatever. She sit there, you know, she listened, you know, she was in a cranky pants like she was this morning with Goodnight Moon. So, I mean, I don't know, we'll try it a couple more times and see what she thinks about it. But I love Scruffy the Tugboat. I love the little golden books, period. Like, I have some more I want to give her. There's, I think, is it the Ugly Duckling? Or the Black Duckling? Something like that with the duck. I want to get that one for her. I want to get the Three Little Pigs. I want to get... there's a bunch of other little golden books that I want to get for. Now, I haven't read all of the little golden books, but there's a lot of little golden books out there. But I want to get her the ones that I know of, that I grew up with, see if she would like them. But I also want to get some new versions too, because they have like Tinkerbell little golden books now, and these last a long time. So I definitely want to get some more of these for her. Okay, so those are the two books that I got for Kalea this month. And on to my books, and I'm going to start with the paperback books that I have. And the first one is something that came out in December that I knew about months ahead of time, that I said I wanted, that I wish I would have got for Christmas, but people in my life don't think books are gifts. Like, they would ask me what I want for Christmas, and I'm like, I want books. Like, prime example, my brother asked me what I wanted for Christmas. I said, I'll give you a list of books that I like, and you can choose from the list and give me some books. This is exactly what he said. Books, what kind of shit is this? Books is not gifts. What is wrong with you? I'm like, because I like to read books. That means it's money I don't have to spend on books. Somebody else can spend them for me. So, I mean, I have a lot of people in my family don't think books are gifts, but to me, books make me happy. Like, my fiance, my birthday's in July. I'm turning 21. Can't wait. We're going to spend a weekend at the casino, y'all. I'm, like, so excited. Okay, but he asked me what I wanted, you know, for my birthday. He don't know. He keeps saying he don't know what he's going to get me for my birthday. Now, he's already thought ahead to Christmas. He knows what he's getting me for Christmas. He knows what he getting me for our anniversary, which is in September. But he don't know what to get me for my birthday. I say, have you seen my bookshelf? You see how I go crazy over books. Books I know I've ordered and I open and I get happy to see them. Buy me books. I could buy you books any day, baby. I say, I know you can buy me books any day, but that's a gift for me. It don't matter what you do. You could piss me off and buy me books and I would love you. I love books. Like, I don't think people understand that shit. Like, I'm not a hard person to buy gifts for. Buy me fucking books. You can get me books or you can get me anything with fucking butterflies on. I don't care. Okay, but I would rather books because that's the less money I have to spend on books. Because y'all know books can get expensive when you're getting a lot of books. So just, I will give you a list of the books that I want. Hell, he knows my password to my Amazon. He can go on Amazon and I leave it logged into on my computer anyway. He can get on my computer, look at Amazon and see the books that's on my wishes and pick from them and have, you know, have a ball. And I would be excited to get books, but it's a hard sell for people in my family to tell them that books are gifts for me. But anyway, now that that rant is over with, the book that I'm talking about that I wanted so much is actually a coloring book, and it came out in December, and I really, really wanted it, and that is the Red Queen coloring book. Oh my god, y'all, like, I was so excited when I heard this was coming out, and I finally went and got, y'all, like, y'all don't know how excited I am, like, yo, I went and bought me some more coloring pencils and everything, y'all. I'm about to turn into this thing. Like, I didn't color it until yet because I wanted to show y'all the blank thing going on. And y'all, it's actually beautiful. They have ones like this that are just like, you know, quotes from the book and stuff. Oh my god, y'all. That's just quotes, right? Look at the pictures, y'all. Look at the pictures, y'all. Like, it looks so good, you know? And look, her ass look evil. She look evil. Y'all, I can't wait to see this. And I know they was talking about, they had talks about a movie deal, whatever, that Victoria Avior was talking to different directors about maybe picking up a movie. If y'all know any more information about that, I would love for y'all to let me know about that, because I would love to see a movie for Red Queen. Like, I think I would be there the day it comes out. I would find a babysitter, whatever it takes, but I would see that movie. Like, I would be the one hyping that movie up, okay? All right. Okay, let me get off of Red Queen for now. Okay, the next book that I have that I got this month before I got this bulk order, the coloring book I got with the bulk order, but before I got this bulk order, I got this. I saw this in Barnes & Noble like a while ago, a few months ago. And when I go on Barnes & Noble, I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I don't buy books at Barnes & Noble. Like, they're too expensive. Unless it's in like the bargain section, or maybe I just really need this one book right now, right then and there. Otherwise, I, you know, take a picture of them, I write the name of them down, because, oh, that sounds interesting, and I go on fucking Amazon and get them, because they're a whole lot cheaper than in Barnes & Noble. I'm sorry. Sorry, Barnes & Noble, but not too expensive. It's called So Sad Today by Melissa Broder, and it's a collection of personal essays by her. Like, she's a poet. I've never read any of her poems, but she's a poet, and this is a collection of essays, and it says, in this darkly funny and brutally honest collection of essays, Melissa Broder grapples with sex, death, love, low self-esteem, anxiety, depression, addiction, and the drama of waiting for the universe to text you back. Doesn't that sound good? Like, don't just sound something like you could really just seep into? Like, y'all, like, I can't wait to read this. I really wanted to pick it up. I'm pretty sure I could sit down and read this in one day, just because it's a collection of essays in maybe 2 days. But I'm not going to say one day I have a baby that demands my attention. So I'm not going to say one day. But maybe 2 days, depending on how long I sit there and read. Yo, this sounds really good. And I can't wait to read this and let you guys know what's up with this book. Because I think this sounds really good. And I hope I don't be let down, because it sounds pretty good. Now, I haven't seen this talked about on BookTube at all. Like, I've literally seen one review for this book. One review for this book on BookTube. I have seen no one else talk about this book or mention this book. I've really read reviews for it on Goodreads, but this isn't really talked about on BookTube. So I hope that it's good, because then I could recommend it to you guys. And I don't know. I don't think this is a new release or anything. I don't know when it came out, though, but I don't think this is a new release. But I hope this is good, because I like to bring new books to the BookTube community, because it seems like pretty much a lot of BookTubers, like a mass majority of the BookTube community, pretty much talks about the exact same books. And I'm not gonna lie, the repetition does get a little bit annoying. Now, I understand that there's some really good books by big name authors that are really good. Like, for me, Red Queen. And that's talked to, you know, that's talked about pretty big on BookTube. So I can understand, you know, like stuff like that, but you don't, but I'm, sometimes you get tired of hearing the people talk about the exact same number of books. And I'm tired of hearing people talking about like the exact same five books. Like every BookTube is talking about the exact same five books. You might get one straight book in there that no one's talking about, but everyone pretty much talks about the same books. And I understand, you know, these are new releases and they are really good, but that's why sometimes I'm like really late to the party. Like I'll get a book that's really hyped about, but I won't read it for months. Like I still have Illuminae. Y'all can't see it, I don't think it's in a shot, but I still have Illuminae sitting on my shelf. I haven't opened yet and I want to read it, but every time I think about it, I'm kind of scared because it's, you know, hyped up so much. I'm scared it's not going to be good, so I'm really nervous about that. I still have Six of Crows sitting on my shelf too, that I got like when it, I pre-ordered Six of Crows. I got that when it first came out and I haven't read it yet. I'm just really nervous about it. Like, it's so hyped up. I'm scared I'm going to be very, very let down. And I don't want that to be the case. So, I just like to bring books to YouTube that maybe people haven't heard about or no one's talking about that might be really good to introduce to you guys. And so, yeah, on to my next book. The next book that I have has been talked about on BookTube. I found out about this from BookTube. I think the first time I heard about this book was from Sasha from A Book Utopia for the first time. And what really caught me was the cover, because I love Paris. I love anything about Paris. It's my first trip out of the country. I want to visit Paris. Okay, like, I don't know why I'm just so hooked on Paris. But it is The Rook by Sharon Cameron. And it's been out for a while. It's not a new release. I think this maybe came out maybe a year, maybe 2 years ago, maybe a year, like a year and a half ago, maybe. And I've been wanting to read it. And I really wanted the hardcover, but I said, okay, maybe I don't want to spend that much money because I'm getting a lot of books. So like, some books I'm going to have to settle for a paperback, because I love hardcover books because they last longer and they're more durable than, you know, paperback. And this is pretty much about post-apocalyptic Paris, okay? And I love, like, post-apocalyptic worlds in books. And I thought this would be really cool because I haven't read anything about Paris, you know, post-apocalyptic Paris. I've never read a book like that. Usually you just see, like, post-apocalyptic world in general. Like, Divergent was, you know, Chicago. And, you know, Match was, we don't fucking know where Match was. But, you know, it's usually just the world as a whole. They don't really center in on, you know, Paris. This is my first time reading post-apocalyptic Paris, so I hope this is gonna be good. I've been wanting to get it, and I finally decided, Kayla, get this goddamn book so you can have it. At least you can know you have it on your shelf. So I don't know, I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I don't know when I'm gonna read this. I don't know when I'm gonna get to it. I have a lot of books on my shelf, so I'm not gonna say I'm gonna get to it this month or next month, because it's gonna be a goddamn lie, and I'm gonna promise that. But when I get to it, y'all will know. The next book that I have, and this is a self-help book, okay? Now, the title is what caught me that made me want to read this book. And it's, I think it's going to be really motivational for me. And it's called You Are a Badass, How to Stop Doubting Your Greatness and Start Living an Awesome Life by Jen Sincero. I haven't searched this on BookTube because I do like to search for, you know, book reviews on BookTube and stuff. So I don't know if this is a book that's talked about on BookTube, but I don't think I've heard anything about it. But doesn't this title make you want to read it? Like, reading this, I feel like I'm going to be walking around saying, yeah, I'm a badass bitch, I could do all of this. And usually I don't call myself a badass bitch, but this book is going to make me, like, feel myself, you know? Because sometimes I do doubt myself and doubt my abilities of what I can and can't do. So hopefully, once I read this book, you know, I can relate to it and be like, oh yeah, I do that sometimes. You know, I do that sometimes. You're right. I need to stop doubting myself. I got this. Yo, I can't wait to read this either. Like, I think I'm really bucked up to read this too. Like, this is the book I'm bucked up for. This is my first self-help book too that I'm going to be reading. So hopefully it goes well. See, one of my reading goals for this year was to venture out and read things that I don't usually read. And I've never read a self-help book before. So this is going to be my self-help book. Hopefully it's good, because there are some more I want to read. I want to read Yes Please by Amy Poehler, but I want to, like, listen to the audiobook for that, because I don't know, I love her voice. Like, I want to hear her, especially since she's narrating her own book. I want to listen to that audiobook for that. So, boom, baby. The next book that I have is a very old book, like, very old. And y'all gonna know what I'm talking about. They had a movie come out for it and everything, which I didn't know this was the book until recently. Like, I knew the movie came out. I wanted to see the movie a long time ago when it came out, but I never seen the movie. And that is Lovely Bones by Alice Sybil. I guess I'm going with that. But I didn't know this was the book. Like, this movie came out a while ago, like a long time ago. Long time ago, I might have been like 8th grade, 7th grade, maybe a freshman. Somewhere in that area was when this book, well, I guess the book came out before, but when the movie came out. And I don't, if I remember correctly, the book is about this girl. She got killed by her neighbor, I think. I don't know how she got killed, but she got killed and her spirit comes back and she's trying to help her dad solve her murder. She's trying to talk to her daddy and communicate with him because he can't hear because she's a ghost. So she's trying to like communicate to him what happened and lead him in the right way to solve her murder. Doesn't that sound fucking good? So it's gonna be a good murder mystery. I want to watch the movie after I read this book. I had no idea it was a book until recently, so I want to watch the movie after I read this. And I know all y'all probably have seen this movie. It came out a very, very long time ago. Like, a long ass time ago. So, I'm gonna let y'all know about this. Okay, the last paperback book that I have is actually a new release. And a lot of people have been talking about it lately. And that is Big Little Lies by Leanne Moriarty. I think I pronounced her name correctly. I hope so. But everybody's been talking about this book. And I did want the hardcover for this too. But When you're buying a lot of books, you gotta compromise and get that price down. But I was pissed off at how I got this book in the box. It seemed like, I kind of straightened the pages out, like, but they threw just about all the paperback books in the same box together. And I think when they dropped the box off, the mailman just dropped it by the door. Because when I got it, all the pages was like crumbled up, like folded up and shit. It's like I was like, this is exactly why I don't get paperback books. But I'm pissed off that, you know, y'all handling my mail like this. Be gentle with my shit. You don't know what's in here, you know. But Big Little Lies by Leanne Moriarty, this is a book that's been talked about a lot recently on BookTube. I heard this for the first time by, can't remember her name, but I think her channel name is Chapter Stacks. And I love watching her videos because the books she reads, all of the books she reads aren't necessarily books that I'm into. Like, she reads a lot of adult novels, adult fiction, but she also reads a lot of horror and mystery books. And I love horror and mystery books, so that's why I'm subscribed to her. And it says, a murder, a tragic accident, or just parents behaving badly. What's indisputable is that someone is dead. Murder mystery, hello. I love a good murder mystery, so hopefully I like this. I don't know if I'm gonna be reading this anytime soon, because like I say, when books are really hyped up, I kind of like to wait a while before I read them. Kind of like to wait for it to die down a little bit, which I don't think is gonna happen anytime soon, especially if there's supposed to be a TV show happening. Everybody's gonna be talking about it for a while. But I'm not even gonna lie, this is not even on the top of my list of books to read that I just bought. So I'm not sure when I'm gonna get to this, but hopefully I get to it before the year is up. That would be amazing if I could, because a lot of times I buy books and it'd be like 2 years before I even read them. Like, I still have freaking Delirium that I never read, that I was supposed to read in February. I've had this book on my shelf for, I don't know, like over two years. I'm just gonna say over 2 years, because I'm not sure if it's 3 years or what. I've had it on my shelf for a while and I've never read it. Okay, on to my hardcover books. Okay, now these first three hardcover books I kind of bought together before I bought the big bulk of books. And the first, and I talked about these books. I said these were going to be the first books that I bought when I got the money to buy books again. Guess what the books, what books they are. The first book that I got is Frost Like Night by Sarah Rush. And I have to say her name slow because I always slur her name together. I'm trying to say it. It's like a tongue twister to me. But y'all, this is the third book in the Snow Like Ashes trilogy, and I'm so excited to read this, and I'm caught up with this trilogy, okay? I read the first and the second book already. This is the last one I have to read, so I'm caught up with this. And it's like, I'm kind of ready for this series, this trilogy to end, you know? Or I'm kind of ready to see the end. It's not like, it's like, I like the trilogy, but it's not like, oh my God, I want to hold on to it. I'm ready for it to be over. Like, the second book kind of gave me anxiety. Like, y'all know, I couldn't even finish reading it. Like, I started it and I had to stop it for a few months and read some other stuff. Because I wasn't ready. I just wasn't ready for anything bad to happen to any of the characters that I liked. But now, I'm ready for this to be over. I'm ready to get rid of this trilogy and kick it. It's not that it's bad at all. It's just something I'm ready to finish and, you know, get out of my system. So, soon I'm going to be reading this. To finish the trilogy off, I'm probably going to be reading it sooner than a lot of the other books that I have. Definitely, because it's a series that I'm currently reading, so I'm definitely going to bump this up the to-be-read line. The second hardcover book that I have, and y'all should know this book that I'm about to tell you about. Y'all should know already. I shouldn't even have to say anything, okay? Yep. King's Cage. I got that. By Victoria Aviar. This is the third book in the Red Queen trilogy. Should be the last book. I don't know. I'm pretty sure it's the last book, but I've seen a couple people talking about it's supposed to be a series. I don't know. I was understanding that it was supposed to be a trilogy. Now, this is a series I'm not ready to end. Like, this is probably going to be part of my TBR for April. Most likely. But yo, I'm not ready for this to end yet. It's like I've been pushing this book off because I could have dropped everything I was reading and started reading this. But I'm not ready for this trilogy to end, you know? Like, I love this trilogy so much, I'm not ready for it to be over. Like, y'all know how I feel about this trilogy. I'm not ready for it to be over, but I'm so ready to see where the fuck we got to pick up off. Because how Glass Sword ended had me pissed off, okay? Like, I mean, not that it was bad, but like pissed off, like mad at what was happening. And I was like, you fucking kidding me? Like, I need the next book now. She better fix this shit. So I don't know, y'all. I'm not ready for this to end. And this is like the biggest book out of all three of the books. This is the biggest one. Like, I'm definitely going to be reading this by itself. There's no way I'm... See, this is 507 pages. Like, there's no way I'm going to be reading this with a Kindle book. This is definitely going to have to be read by itself. And the sad part about it is I love these books so much and I always get through these books so fast. It's 507 pages, but I guarantee you I can be done it in a week. Because I'm going to start reading it, and this is that series. This is that book that I love so much I'm not going to put down. I'm going to want to finish it off. So, y'all wish me luck when I start reading this, because I'm kind of nervous. I'm scared to see how this is going to end. Whew. The third hardback cover that I have, which is also the second book to a series that I'm reading, which is also a book, one of the three books that I said I was getting when I got paid, okay? Which I absolutely love the first book, and I'm going to absolutely link the review in the eye so you guys can go and look at my review, because I did a good ass review for this book. Y'all need to go look at it, alright? And that is A Torch Against the Night by Saba Tahir. Okay, I love the first book, and the cliffhanger that the first book left off on, y'all know how it had me. Like, if y'all don't, go watch my review so y'all can see how the cliffhanger had me. Like, I can't wait to read this book. The first book has so much action in it, and I just loved it so much. I can't wait to get freaking sucked into this book, and it should be no problem. Like, I'm ready to solve mysteries and shit. Yo, if y'all have not read it, Ember in the Ashes, go fucking read that book. This is the second book to that series. Y'all need to go read Ember in the Ashes. I recommend that top. Okay, and when I read this the same year that I read Red Queen. And I said those are my top two favorite books, that Ember and the Ashes gave Red Queen a run for its money. So you know it's got to be good, knowing how much I love Red Queen. And I can say that Ember and the Ashes gave Red Queen a run for its money. Like, these are the top two, like, my top two favorite series that I've read. And Ember and the Ashes has so much, just so much action in it. Y'all need to go pick that up. Check it out from the library. I don't care, but y'all need to read that. It's good. Trust me, it is good. I wouldn't lie to y'all. I wouldn't lead y'all wrong. Go read that book so y'all could be ready for my review when I read this book, which is going to be very soon. It's very at the top of my TBR list, okay? Okay, guys, so this next book that I have It's called Little Peach by Peggy Kern or Karen. I don't know. It's K-E-R-N. I don't know how you would pronounce that. But it's a very short book. I don't think it's 200 pages. Yeah, it's not even 200 pages. It's 190 pages. It's a very short book. And how big the words are, I'm pretty sure you can finish that in one sitting, which I'm probably going to try to when I read it like that. I'm probably going to try to finish it in one sitting. But I heard about this book off a like relatively new booktuber's channel. I can't remember the name of the channel, but I'll figure it out and link it down in the description box below, because it was a little while ago I saw the video, but it definitely made me want to get this book. Okay, now this is about this girl. I'm not even gonna read the thing, so don't ask me what their name is. This is about this girl. Her mom has a drug problem. She ends up running away from home because her mom has a drug problem, but she ends up running away from home and running into the arms of a pimp who she didn't know was a pimp at the time, but she soon finds out he's a pimp and he's pimping her out. Okay, and it's about her trying to get away from her. Now, that sounds good, and because it's so short, I know it's going to be action behind action. It's not a long enough book to make you bored. It's the perfect size book for the perfect size plot. Does that make sense? Like, it's not enough room, not enough pages in this book for it to slow down or to be bad. I hope not. But this sounds fucking good. Tell me this don't sound good. When I'm done reading this, I'm definitely going to come back and tell y'all about it. Because when I heard her talk about this, I was like, fucking right. That sounds good. I need to pick that up. And I probably would have never heard about this book had it not been for her. Never would have heard about it. Because I haven't heard anyone else on BookTube talk about this except for her. So, be looking out for that. So, y'all, I'm kind of pissed off right now because I finished this whole video. And so, I went to go and stop it and noticed my fucking camera decided to go to sleep while we was recording. So, I guess that's a setting I need to see on my camera, because I guess this is a long video. I haven't done a video this long before. The motherfucker cut off on me while I was filming. So, I'm down to my last three books, but it cut off my last three books, so yeah, I'm so drove right now. I guess that's a setting I need to see. Like, what camera goes to sleep while I'm fucking recording? The audacity. Alright, y'all, I gotta hurry up and do this last three books, because I'm pretty sure Kalia's gonna be waking up pretty soon. And I was trying to finish this video before she woke up, and she's been asleep a while now, so I'm pretty sure she's gonna be waking up pretty soon, so I need to run through this video and hurry this process up, because she's a cranky pants and she has to wait on me, and I don't want that problem. So, here we go. Backtrack into the book that I was on when the video cut off, which is a new release. I'm trying to be happy now, because now that I got that out of my system and try to do this quick before it cuts off on me again. This is the new release that everyone on BookTube is talking about, and it is The Hate You Give by Angie Thomas. Okay, I think this came out in February. I wanted to read this a while ago. Yeah, like, I feel like I'm literally repeating myself, but you gotta do what you gotta do. I wanted to read this when it came out. Like, it was on my radar before it came out, but like I said, money problems when you not working and you on maternity leave, bills come first. But boom, here it is, I got it. I'm probably not gonna read it for a few more months because it's still brand new and everybody's like talking about it. I'm probably gonna wait a month, maybe 2 months, before I actually read this and let the hype die down some. And if y'all don't know, this book is like basically surrounding the Black Lives Matter culture. I don't know the characters' names. I think the boy name is Khalil, but it's about this girl. She and her friend Khalil live in a poor neighborhood, but they go to this like preppy rich school, and it's about them on their way home one day. I don't know if they was on their way home from school, on their way home from a party, but Khalil ends up getting shot by the police, and I think he ends up dying from getting shot by the police. And she was the only one that witnessed the shooting, so it's on her to pretty much, you know, say everything that happened. And people at school are saying that, oh, he was a thug, or maybe he was a drug dealer, or he deserved it. Which is the fucking reality that we live in today. This is kind of stuff that goes on in America, because I've seen a lot of booktubers say, you know, well, you know, the ones that aren't in America, that, you know, they don't have issues like that in their country, so they don't, you know, they didn't know that it was still like that. It's still like that, okay? It's not as bad as it used to be, but as you can see, it's coming back around, you know? But that's what this book is about, and I'm hoping I don't get pissed off while I read this book. Not because the book might be bad, but because, like, reading content like this, even watching movies that's like this, it pisses me off with like the world we live in. Like, you know, like it really has me like feeling some type of way after. Like, usually every year for Black History Month, they play Roots and stuff. I can't watch that. I get pissed off and I take it out on people. You know, people that has done nothing to me, but I get upset with it. So I hope this book doesn't do this to me, because I heard really good things about the book. And I'm not worried that the book is going to be bad. I'm just worried about the content making me, you know, pissed off, because that usually what happens with me. So I hope that that doesn't happen with me with this book. Yo, did y'all look at the back of this book? Did y'all notice this? It's a dude with a hoodie. Like, can y'all see that? Can y'all see that? Like, I paid no attention to the back of the book. I saw the shininess of his skin, and I was like, what is that? And I was like, yo, that's tight. That's tight. I like that. I like that. That's brownie points. That's tight. I don't have no books like that. That's tight. The second to last book I was talking about before the camera cut off, which I think is a new release, and by this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful fucking girl that I didn't even know wrote a book, okay? It's called I Don't Belong to You, Quiet the Noise and Find Your Voice by Kiki Palmer. I love Kiki. I'm a Kiki fan, okay? I didn't know Kiki wrote a book, but I'm excited to read this fucking book, okay? I'm excited to read this shit. This is pretty much her giving inspiration to fucking women, you know? And the book itself is fucking beautiful. Look at this. Beautiful. This is the first time I've seen this page. This is beautiful, okay? And not just that, it has emojis on every freaking page, emojis in the text. So it looks very down to earth. And then not only that, when you get to a new chapter, check that out. That's fucking pretty. This book is gonna be fun to read because the writing is so beautiful. And it's like, y'all, I'm inspired already. This is beautiful. I can't wait to read this. This is not a book I've ever heard about on YouTube. So hopefully I can come back to y'all with a great review for this book and get some of y'all out there to read this book, because it seems like it's going to be pretty damn good and motivational, and it's a beautiful book. So if y'all one of them people that like to buy books just to, you know, decorate y'all shelf, y'all should still buy this anyway, because this is a pretty book, you know. Go pick that shit up if y'all that type of person. If you care about the content, you might have to wait till my review though before I can tell you to go pick it up, because I don't know yet. I love her, but I'm gonna be honest about the book, about what I'm receiving from it, okay? So y'all just keep watching for this, okay? Keep watching. All right, the last book that I'm about to talk about, hopefully the damn camera don't cut off since this is gonna be a relatively short section of the video, is Age of Myth, Book 1 of the Legends of the First Empire by Michael J. Sullivan. And this is a YA fantasy. It's a fantasy novel. I'm pretty sure it's YA. Not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure it's YA. This is like one of those rebellion books, you know, about, you know, people rebelling and everything. I will read the excerpt to y'all because I think that does it more justice. Okay. Since time immemorial, humans have worshipped the gods they call Frey. Truly a race apart. Invincible in battle, masters of magic, and seemingly immortal. But when a god falls to a human blade, the balance of power between humans and those they thought were gods changes forever. Not only a few stand between humankind and annihilation. Frey, reluctant to embrace his destiny as the god killer, and I don't know if that's how you pronounce his name. Suri, a young seer burdened by signs of impending doom, and Persephone, who must overcome personal tragedy to lead her people, which is a pretty ass name. The age of myth is over. The time of rebellion has begun. Doesn't that sound good? I love a good rebellion, fantasy, dystopian kind of book, right? Doesn't everybody want that? Don't you want a cup of dystopian with your book of tea in the morning? See how I switched that around, huh? It might not have been too good. It's actually kind of corny when I think about it, but I try, y'all. I try. I'm trying to make myself laugh because I'm pissed off that I have to record this part all over again. But I can't wait to read this. This might be something I read in a month or two. I'm not going to say I'm reading that because I actually have kind of like a list of books that I want to read soon. So I'm not going to say I'm reading this immediately. But maybe before June, I want to say I'm going to pick this up. All right. That's a good estimate. That's a good estimate. So, y'all, I can't wait to show y'all this. Okay, y'all, that's all I have for my book haul this month. All right, again. But I'm not going to hold these books up because I'm scared as hell I'm going to drop them. So I'm going to have to try to balance them for my thumbnail, though. So hopefully that goes good. But y'all see, looking at whatever thumbnail y'all get, what I decided to do. But thank you guys so much for watching my video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.
it's hit, and no one understands.